My name is Tushar Sharma, and here I'm going to discuss with you about app resources and supporting multiple screens. In this session, we will cover app resource definition, type of resources, resource directory tree structure, then type of resource directories and assets. After that, we will see one example to see the implementation of different type of resources. Then we will cover supporting multiple screens, density independence, and screen compatibility example. Now, first of all, app resources. What are app resources? Resources are additional declarative files and static contents. Means these are external files in which we declare our resources once and use in our Java program at Java code and XML file at any time. But all the modification will be saved at the compilation time only. But no changes and no changes occur at the runtime. So Android creates the resource ID for using them in Java programs. So for accessing these resources, we need to access the R class file. As we had discussed in the previous session, R class file is used to create the different IDs for the different type of resources. Now, type of resources. There are different type of resources which can be possible in the Android is string resources. String resources is used to provide the text string, and these can be accessed by the r.string.stringname. This r is the class file name. Then after the dot, we need to pass the type of resources which we want to refer. Then among those resources, we need to select the particular resource name by using the resource name. Then color resources. Color resources are used to define the color set for the project, and we can refer them by the r.color.colorName. Then style and theme resources are used to define the look and format for the project. They can be accessed by the r.style.styleName. Then dimension resources. Dimension resources carries the unit of the measure of the dimension or the size, and now dimension can be of different types like points, inches, scale independent pixel, density independent pixel. These are defined by the Android libraries, so we need to follow only those dimensions which are defined in Android only. Now another is the color drawable resources. Color drawable resources is used to define the to fill the canvas, or we can define the we can create the color rectangle using the color drawable resources. Now color drawable resources are accessed by the r.drawable.rectangleGreen, which is the name of the particular color drawable. And then another way to access the color drawable is r.values.rectangleGreen, because the color drawable resources can be stored in a drawable or the value subdirectory. Now another is the drawable resources. Drawable resources are used to define the bitmaps, nine patches, and other XML file, and they can be accessed by the r.drawable.imageName or the file name, any file name. Now layout resources are used to define the application user interface, as we discussed in a previous session. Then if they are referred by the r.layout.layoutName. Here the layout name is the app resources. Now another is the manage resources. Manage resources are used to define the application manage, which is appear on the layout by clicking the menu option, as we discussed. Then they are referred by the r.menu.menuName. Another is the animation. Animation resources can be animation resources is used to put the animation on the object, and they can be categorized as the property animation, frame animation, and view animation. Actually, the animation can be, animation is only of two types, which is the property animation and twin animation. For more clarification, this twin animation is categorized as frame animation and view animation. Now, they can be referred by the r.animation subdirectory. We need to create the separate subdirectories for defining the animation, then dot the animation file name. Now, for understanding how and these resources are stored in our project, have a look at the resource directory tree structure. On the top of the tree structure, you can see the, this is the this is the root directory of the project. Under this root directory, there are different types of folder are created. Between these folder, there is a assets also, which we will discuss in our next slide. Then there is a resource folder. Resource folder is used to contain the different type of resource subdirectories, like drawable resource subdirectory, layout resource subdirectory, menu resource subdirectory, value subdirectory, and the drawable subdirectory and the value subdirectories are further classified, further categorized. Now, drawable subdirectory can be of SD, can be categorized as SDPI, LDPI, MDPI, XSDPI. In SDPI, the images of high density are stored. Then drawable LDPI is used to store the devices images of the low density. Then MDPI is used to store the images of the medium density, and XSDPI is used to store the images of the extra high density. Depend upon your screen configuration, you have to store the drawable resources into the their particular subdirectories. Now layout subdirectory is used to store the layout resources only, and menu subdirectory is used to store the menu resources. Value subdirectory is used to store the multiple type of resources like string resources, style resources, color resources, color drawable resources, and dimension resources, and some other kind of the resources are possible in the value subdirectory, which are like the boolean and some other. Now here you can see the value is also categorized as the three folders. The values folder is used to store the XML files or the resource file by which are used by default. Then values v11 is used to store the style XML file, which is used to support the Android 3.0 or the below version. Then values v14 is used to support the XML file, of the Android version above than 3.0. This is the resource directory tree structure, which is created by default, but we can use some other subdirectories to create in this folder for using the other type of resources like the animation, XML and the raw. We can include this in by manually creating the file subdirectories. Now, the other different type of resource directory which can be possible in an Android project are anim subdirectory, animator subdirectory, drawable subdirectory, layout subdirectory, menu subdirectory, raw subdirectory, then the value subdirectory and the XML subdirectory. Now, anim subdirectory is used to store the view animation, and animator subdirectory is used to store the property animation. Actually, anim subdirectory is used to can be used to store the any kind of the twin animation. Now, drawable subdirectory is used to store the drawable resources or the color drawable resources. Then layout subdirectory is used to store the XML files which is used to define the layout for the project. Menu subdirectories are used to define the XML file or the resource file for the menu resources. Then raw subdirectory is used to store the raw files. Raw files are actually the any read only files like the audio or the video. Value subdirectory is used to define store the multiple type of resources like color resources, color drivable resources, dimension resources, string resources, style resources, and some other as we discussed earlier. Now XML folder, is used to store the XML file which is used at the runtime only. So that's why we had created the XML file, XML folder also in our resource directories. Another is the assets. Assets, as we had seen in a previous tree structure, is defined, is created by default when you create any Android project for storing the raw assets files, and files saved in the assets directories are not given the resource ID. The main difference between the raw and the assets are this, assets resources are not given the resource ID, so we cannot access the assets by referring to the R class file. So we can refer them by the like the normal file system file, and by passing the URL into the location, and reads the raw data using the assets manager. While the raw resources are created manually in the resource subdirectory, and they can be they are given the resource ID for accessing the any kind of the resources defined in the raw folder. Raw folder is also used to store the read only files like the assets, and files that save in the assets are used at the are compiled into the .apk file. Then assets are more flexible and functionally provide the more functionality than the raw. We can list the assets subfolders into the assets directory, and we cannot list the raw files in a raw subdirectory. Now assets can be accessed by using the assets manager. So here, by these two lines of code, we can access the assets in our project. Assets are accessed by the creating the object of the asset manager, which call the get assets function. Then this get object call the open function, and in this open function we pass the parameter as a some raw file which we want to read. Assets store the approximately maximum size of 1 MB file. Now after this we are going to see the implementation of these different type of resources, then we will cover supporting multiple screen, and I will explain each code. So this is the resource this is the tree structure of the resource directory as I had shown you in the snapshot. Then under this go to the resource directory. Under this resource directory, different type of resource subdirectories are created, like anim, drawable, layout, menu, values. Here drawable, layout, menu and values are by default created, but anim we have to create manually for using the animation resources. Now for creating the first, we are going to cover and see the use of the layout resources. So this is the Eclipse view of the project. So in this this is the project root directory. Under this root directory there is a resource directory. In this resource directory, different type of resource subdirectory we can create, like anim, drawable, layout, menu, values. In Between these, the drawable layout menu and values are by default created, but others for the other type of resources, we need to create the subdirectories. Like anim, we have to create manually. XML folder, we can create manually. Now, for first, we are going to see the use of the layout resources. For layout resources, go to the resource directory. Under this resource directory, find the layout subdirectory. Under this layout subdirectory, you can create your own XML file by right click and adding the XML file to this for creating your layout resources. We are going to see the only the use of the application user interface. So we are not going to discuss very much about the layout as we had discussed in a previous session. So have a look at the appresource.xml, which is the main.xml. Main.xml or the appresource.xml is used to define the application user interface. When we go inside this XML file, we can see relative layout is by default present. Relative layout is used to define the project properties or the feature which will first appear when you click the APK file. Under this, we define the project properties like under this resource file in the under this relative layout, different type of project properties are defined. Like text view is the one properties of the project which we want to display in a relative layout. Then another text view is also present here. Then button. After that, image view. These items will be displayed in a relative layout as a output. So whenever we run the project, this image view, button, and the text view are appear as a output on the relative layout. As we had discussed in a previous session of the widgets and the layout, so we are not going to discuss their properties. So in this way, but appresource.xml is by default created, so we need not to create application user interface. We define only the properties of the appresource.xml. Now for using the appresource.xml or the main layout as a output for the project, go to the appresource directory, root directory. Under this root directory, go to the source directory. In this, you can find the packages defined. In this package, go to the appresource.java. So for accessing the layout, main layout XML file as a output of the application user interface, so set the content view function as a reference of this relative layout. Now set content view is in under this set content view function, we had passed the reference of the relative layout. In this function, in this reference, R is the class file in which different resource IDs are created. Then layout is the particular type of resource which we want to display. Like here, I want to display the layout resources. Then app resource is the particular layout resources which I want to display as a output. So in this way, I have displayed my appresource.xml as a output of the application user interface. So whenever we click our APK file, this appresource.xml content are displayed as a output. So by calling the function setContentView. Now another kind of the resources is the string resources. For string resources, go to the value subdirectory under the resource directory, and you can add your own XML file for creating the string resources, or here by default strings.xml is present. So I'm using this strings.xml for creating the resources. When you click this strings.xml, the two kind of the tab is present here, resources and the string.xml. Means there are two possible ways for creating the XML resources in your project. One is the by using the resource element, resource file, and another is the strings.xml file. In this resource file, you can find different types of the resource element are defined. This is the icon for the string resources, then color resources, then drawable, then dimension, then style, item, string array, and the integer array element. And this is another for the plurals of the string. Now, for creating using the resource element is provided by the Android libraries to create your project without writing any code. So just click the add button, select the resource which you want to create, like color, dimension, drawable, integer array, item, and different type of resources are present which we can create. Now for creating the string resources, select the string and click the OK. In the right side of the page, you can find two text fields are defined. First is the name text field. In name text field, you have to pass the name of the resource. Name of the resource is actually used to refer the project. Means by the name we can only access the project. Like in the widgets, we had find that we are accessing by the IDs. In this resources, we can access by the resource name. Then string is the resource name. Then pass the value of the string which you want to display as a output. Like I want to display, this is string using the resource element. So in this way, we can create the string resources by using the resource element. Another way is by using the strings.xml. For string.xml, I do not use this resource for the output, so I can delete this. So just I remove this. So I'm going to show you the creating the resources by using the string.xml. The same string I can create using the string.xml. In string.xml, just open the tag and pass the particular tag name which you want to use for the resources. Like I want to create the string resources, so I created the string tag. Into this string tag, first set the properties of the tag by name which we required to refer the project. So I set the name for the this particular string as a Android workshop. Then pass the value in between the tags which you want to display as a output, like this is a Android workshop. Now in this way we can create the string resources by using the string.xml. And another way we had seen that by using the resource element. In the resource element, this name tag is provided, name text field is provided to create the name, and the value is provided, value field is provided to pass the value, but here we are doing different thing, different by a different way for creating the same resources. So we do not use this string as a output, so I can delete this. So this is the two ways for creating the particular string for particular resources using the resource element and using the XML file of that resource. Now for using the string resources, two ways are possible: appresource.xml and appresource.java. In appresource.xml, let's say I want to display this string on a text view. So I want to display this string in a text view. For this purpose, I set the text property of the text view as a reference to the particular string, where at the rate is used for reference purpose, and here we can pass the particular type of resource which we want to access. Like I want to access the string resource, so I write the string, then after the slash you need to pass the name of the particular string which you want to display as a output. So three things we need to pass into this text property: at the rate, then at the rate for reference purpose, then type of resource, then name of the resource. So in this way we can access the particular string. Android is the another string which we have defined in a string.xml file. And its value is Android workshop. Now another way is by using the appresource.java. You can see the appresource.xml, I had also created the another text view. In this text view, I had passed the reference for the another string. String resources. So here both the same string are present, so I just change the one string name. So one string is displaying the this is a string as a output, and another will display the Android workshop as a output. So another way for referring the using that is string.xml is appresource.java. For this purpose I will change this name, so both the text view will display the same output, which is the Android workshop. So go to the appresource.java. In this, for displaying the output in a text view, we need to first access the text view. So in this way we can access the text view, as we had discussed in a previous session. So for accessing the string resources, we need to first create the string variable. In string variable we need to store the string resources. For storing the string resources into this variable, we need to first access the different type of resources which can be used in a Android project by using the getResources function. GetResources function is used to access the all the type of resources in a project. Among getResource function is used to access the all the different kind of resources which is created in a project. Then among those different type of resources, I have to select the string resources. So I need to pass the get string function. We need to just write the get and type the type of the string resources. Like I want to access the string resources, so pass the get string function. So into this get string function, just pass the reference to the particular string which you want to appear as a output. So r dot r is the class file name as we discussed, then string is the particular type of resource like string resource here, then name of the particular string which you want to display as a output. So we need to pass the reference to the particular string in a get string function. So in this way we had accessed the get string function and stored this into the string variable. Now if I want to display this string as a output on a text view 1, so I set the text view 1, I call the text view 1 property which is set text and pass the parameter as a variable of the string resources. Then this particular string is replaced into the text view. Like we had seen previously that in both the text view I had defined the same string like Android workshop. So now I had replaced the this string by string resources, which will display this is a string as a output in this particular text view. Now if we run this project, then this will appear as a output. I had already run this project for saving the time. So you can see this. The one is the first is the Android workshop string I had written using the app resource.xml, and another is also written by using the app resource.xml, but that value is the Android workshop. But using the app resource.java, I changed this value as a this is a string. So another this text view will change to the this is a string as a output using the app resource.java. So in this way you can create and use the string resources. So there are the similar way for creating and using the different type of resources. Now we are going to see the use of the color resources. Color resources are also stored in a value subdirectory. So create the XML file for the color resources in a value subdirectory. For this, go to the color.xml. I'm using the same file which is present in a this value subdirectory. In color subdirectory color.xml, open the color tag for the color using the color resources. In this color resources, in this color tag, pass the name which you want to refer for this particular color. Then between this color tag, pass the value of the color which you want to display. Like here we have defined the hash 0FF. It is defined by the and it is defined by the predefined format of the Android, which support the some hash RGB format, hash RGB GGB format, and some other format which is defined by the Android only. So this is the hash RGB format. In this format, for using the particular resources, you need to set the value is F, and for not using the particular color, pass the value as a 0. Like hash RGB is using the green and blue color. So it is the mixture of the green and blue color, but we are not using the red color, so put the value of the red is 0. So in this way we can create the different type of color combination. Another way is by resource element. In a resource element, the similar way is for creating the resources, click the add button and just add the particular type of resources. But here you can see the these are the predefined format in which we can declare, in which we can use the value of the curler resources, like #RGB, #ARGB, #RRGGB or #AARRGGBB. So we can, in this way we can implement different type of color in our project. So this is the two way for both the ways for creating the color.xml or color resources. So for another way for creating the color.xml is, we can also create the color.xml into the any XML file which is present in a value subdirectory, because color resources are defined in only the value subdirectories. So we can use any XML file for creating the color resources, like string.xml. I am creating the color in a string.xml. Just you need to only keep that in mind that color tag is used for the color resources, for creating the color resources. In color tag, you need to pass the name of the particular color for you for referencing purpose, then pass the value of the color. As I had told earlier, so we can, I had created here yellow and a red green color. For yellow, I use the mixture of the red and green, and this is the another color. Now, for using the color resources, go to the, either you can go to the appresource.xml or appresource.java. As I told you, that two ways are possible for. Now, appresource.xml, I want to set the text view color as I had, which I had defined in a color.xml. Set the text color property of the text view for changing the color of the text, like @color, @rate is used for reference, then color is the type of resource, then green blue is the particular color name which I want to display on this text view. So this text view output will appear in this color format. Now another is the appresource.java. By using appresource.java, you can also use the color resources, but color resources are only stored in a integer variable. So I need to create the integer variable for storing the color resources. In this integer variable, I first call the get resource function for accessing the different type of resources. Among those resources, I had called the get color function for accessing the color resources. This is used for selecting the particular resources among the different type of resources. Then pass the parameter into this function as a reference to the particular color, like r.color.colorName, where color is defining the color resources here. Now if I want to set this color in a background of a layout, so I need to first assess the relative layout. For this purpose, this code will assess the relative layout. We had discussed in a previous session of the layouts. By using the view, we can assess the relative layout, then set the background of the relative layout by the color which we had defined. So for setting the background, we need to call the set background color function, because we are changing the background color. So pass the color variable into this background color function. So now the color is changed to yellow. So yellow may not look good. So I can change the color here by 0F, as I had told. I'd asked to change the color of this, so I'm just changing the color. And if I run the project, just save the file. And just need, you can see the current output of this project. The color is changed to the pink. Now it's look fine. Now another type of resources are dimension resources. For creating the dimension resources, create the resource file in a value subdirectory only, because the dimension resources is also stored in a value subdirectory. So in value subdirectory, create the XML file for dimension, and into this dimension XML file, you can create the dimension by either using the resource element and or using the dimension.x or the XML file. So I'm only going to show the use of the dimension.xml because the time is less. So for creating the dimension resources, open the dimension tag. Into this dimension tag, set the name which you want to refer for the particular dimension. Then pass the value of a dimension in a defined format of the dimension in an Android, like pixel, this is for density independent pixel, then scale independent pixel, and there is a, and pass the magnitude before these units. Now I had created the three type of dimension here. Now for using this dimension, go to the app-resource.xml. In app-resource.xml, I want to change the dimension of the text view. Text view 1. So text view 1 property, text size, is changed to this particular dimension. Into this text size property, pass the reference to the particular dimension which you want to display as a output. So at the rate diamond is used for assessing the dimension. Here diamond is using for assessing the dimension resource, because the diamond tag we had used in a project. Then pass the name of the dimension which you want to display. So in this way you can implement the dimension in on your text view. So this text view object will appear in this particular dimension format. Now another way is the app-resource.java. Now dimension resources are only stored in a float type variable. So into this float type variable, pass the reference to the dimension resources by get resource function and get dimension for assessing the dimension. The similar way for like the different resources we had used, then pass the reference to the particular dimension which you want to implement. Then set the text view 1 text size by calling the set text size function, and pass the parameter as a reference to the particular dimension. So in this way you had implemented the dimension resources. You have seen both the way of implementing the dimension resources. Now another kind of the resource is the style.xml. Style is the another resource file which is present in a value subdirectory by default. We can either create our own XML file, but I'm using this XML file for creating my another style resource. I'm just showing the style.xml implementation, not the resource implementation. So for creating the style, open the style tag, pass the name of the style which you want to refer. Then style is the only type of resource which has the property of the inheritance. It will inherit the characteristic of its parent by passing the parent name into the parent function. So it can inherit the property of the of its parent. As you have defined, the parents is app based theme. So we can define the properties, different properties of the particular style, like text color, text size, and text style. These are different property. Some other properties we can use for the styling, like text color is set to has 00f in a defined format of the color. Then size is set in a defined format, like the scale independent pixel. Then text style is set to bold. So in this way we had created the style dot style resources. Another way is by using the resource element. In this you need to first click the resource and click the add button, then create a new element, new type of resources. For new style resources, click the new element at the top level in resources, then select the style or theme, then pass the name of the style. Style Android, then parent name which you want to inherit, like I want to inherit app based theme which is defined here. This parent I want, this style I want to use as a parent. Then after creating this style, you can implement the different properties into this style by just click the add button and select a create a new element in the selected element only. Means in this style you are inserting the item to define the properties of this style. Then set the name and a properties as we had seen in the style.xml, different properties like text color, text size. Then I'm not going to use, so I have to remove this also. So in this way you can create your own style resources. Now for using the style resources, either go to the resource.xml or in a text view, if you want to use this style resources, set the text set the style property of a text view and pass the reference to this to the particular type of style resources in a similar way as we discuss for the another kind of the resources. Now another is the app resource.java. Using the app resource.java, you can also implement the style resources by calling the set text appearance function onto the particular text view in which you want to implement the style resource. Then into this we need to pass the two parameter. First is the get application context is used for assessing the different application support resources and the class and other file name file properties. Then another is the r dot style dot style name, which is the reference to the particular type of resources. So in this way I had set that style on this particular text view. So another is the so values, all the values resources are over, but color drawable is left. So let's see the color drawable, but we are going to use the color drawable resources. Color drawable resources I had defined in a color.xml file. Color.xml, I had told that color drawable resources is used for creating the colored rectangle. So for creating the color drawable resources, we need to create open the drawable tag. But the drawable tag value is set to some color value, so it is used for defining the color rectangle. And the name we need to pass for accessing the particular color drawable resources. So in this way, we had created the color drawable resources. For accessing the color drawable resources, go to the app resource.java and create the color drawable object here, and we need to typecast it because we are accessing the drawable tag. So this is used for specifying that this is color drawable resource only, and get resource function is used for accessing the color different type of resources. Then get drawable is for accessing this color drawable resources or the color drawable resources. Then pass the parameter into this function as a reference to the particular color drawable resources. Then set this color drawable onto the background of the particular text. So set background drawable as the reference to the particular color drawable object. Then another is the, in this way we had implemented the color drawable resources. Now another is the menu resources. For menu resources, we had seen in our previous session, so I'm not going to discuss it very much. Just see the XML file. We need to just create the item as we have seen in a previous session and set its properties like ID for accessing the particular item, title is which we want to display on our output, which is about and help, two item I had created in a menu. Then in this way we had created the menu.xml. So go to the app resource.java for accessing the menu resources and go to the on create option menu function, and into this function parameter is the menu object. Then call the get menu inflator function for using the menu resources and call its inflate function to invoke this menu resources on your application manners. Then we need to pass the two reference two parameter like reference to the particular menu and the object of the this function, and this is the boolean type function, so it will return true. We need to define the true after creating all the type of menu which you want to display. So another type kind of the resource is the drawable resource. For drawable resources, add the images into the particular drawable subdirectory depend upon your screen size configuration. And use the drawable resources by this app resource and by this code. The similar code is present, so we need not to discuss. After that, so in this way we had used the drawable resources. So last is the animation is left. So animation will be more explained in a next presentation on a particular animation only. So as a limit on our time, so I'm not going to discuss animation resources, but I had created the two XML file for animation. This is for view animation and this is for frame animation. Into this, just set the frame animation property which display the sequence of images, and view animation is used to rotate, scale or translate the object. So now we can see the object output. So that the rotating button is showing the view animation by just setting the rotate property into the view animation file. Then when we click the button, then in this particular image view, this is displaying the sequence of images as a output, which is used by the frame animation. In frame animation, we had declared the several type of images in our item tag, and so in this way we can use the different type of resources. Now we are going to quickly see the supporting multiple screen properties. So as the Android runs on a variety of the devices, so it supports the multiple screen. Multiple screen depend upon the some screen characteristic like size, density, aspect ratio and orientation. Now size is the size of the layout. Density is the physical measure of the layout. Then aspect ratio is the nothing but a resolution only. Orientation is the alignment when we rotate the device. So size can be small, normal or large. Small size is range from 426 dp into 320 dp, where dp is the density independent pixel. Then normal is the range from 470 dp into 320 dp, and large size screen is range from 640 dp into 480 dp. You can say follow this chart for analyzing the ranges of the different screen support properties. Now another is the, we can set the as screen support property by modifying the manifest.xml, and some screen support properties are large screen, normal screen, small screen, resizable and any density. For Android version 3.0 or below, these are set to true, but for the above, these are set to any density is set to false for below version. Now density independence is used to express the layout dimension or a position in a density independent way. We can see these three images. First is high density, second is low density, second is medium density, and third is low density. For more explanation, you can go to this link. Now screen compatibility example. In first image, you can see the normal size, normal density. Normal size means the layout size is normal. Means any image of the large size is completely fit to the screen. And normal density means the less number of the pixel is present in a display area than the large density. You can see the another image of the normal size and high density. Both the image of normal size means both cover the same, both cover the full screen. Then the density is in the first image normal density, and the second image is the high density. In normal density, it will cover less number of the dots per inches. Then another is will cover more points in this display area. Now you can see third image. In the third image and the first image, you can see the difference normal size and the large size. Normal size means layout size is normal, so any image will completely cover the whole area of the layout. But if the layout size is large, so image is not able to completely fit to the layout. Then in a high density, and the high density, as I discussed, it will cover more points, so it will cover the maximum area than the normal density large size. Now summary, as we had discussed earlier, resources are declarative files and static contents. Then resource directory tree structure we had discussed. Then supporting multiple screen properties and density independence. For the more explanation, go to these links and this book for more explanation. So Thank you, everyone.